What up? Unbreakable Kicks Army. Man, I'm thinking about starting a segment over here called the Sneaker Horror Stories because, man, some of the stories that I've been seeing and reading regarding sneakers have been crazy. But Army, on the plus side, I can't let y'all know, the vault is pretty clean. You know, I'm still working on moving some of the PEs on this side over there so I can display some of the new joints that I just picked up. If y'all ain't see that video, you are missing a banger. So make sure you go and check out the video that I did 2 days ago. And also make sure you check out the video that I posted yesterday regarding just a conversation if StockX is truly controlling the sneaker market or not. It was a good topic. A lot of members of the Army was giving their feedback. And that's what I love about the Army. Just that we give our feedback. We try to help out as much as possible. Now, so here we are. Today on Facebook, man, I ran across a Facebook post that was kind of, I wouldn't even say it was kind of an alarming post, but it was just one of those posts as far as kind of like a learning, could be a learning lesson for me, could be a learning lesson for anybody. And I like that some of the members of the Facebook sneaker community, they aren't afraid to just tell, you know, their story or, you know, if something went good or if something went wrong. So it was a post that I came across, and a lot of the people who was commenting under, I know them or I know of them. And, you know, we were all just wishing the best of this individual, hoping things go right. So he posted and said, "Hey guys, so a few weeks ago, I posted about my Off-White Chicagos. These joints right here. Now, I UNDS'd my Off-White Chicago Sneaker Con Chicago 2019. And from then to now, the price of the Air Jordan 1 Chicago Off-White has probably gone up about $1,500 to $2,000 since the end of 2019. Well, let's start it over. "Hey guys, so a few weeks ago, I posted about how my Off-White Chicagos went missing in transit to StockX on June 1st. He said, "After about a week, I reached out to them. They had asked for a drop-off receipt, but since it was a residential pickup, I didn't get provided one. Last time this happens, my fault." So I want to stop right there. Yeah, Army, sometimes we can use other people's mishaps or other people's blessings, however it may be, as a form to either walk one way or walk another way. And this is so crazy because I recently just sold a pair of Jordan 1 Women Lows. I just recently sold a pair of those on StockX. Now, I wasn't really feeling like going to UPS. Now, UPS pretty much comes to the crib every other day. So I was literally just going to give them that box so they could scan it right there and just take it with them. And then, you know, it goes on its way from there. Of course, when you do a residential pickup, you know, they scan a package and you can just track it from there on out. And hopefully the person is responsible and truthful and they not just gonna take your package and then you out of luck. So that's honestly a lot of trust you are putting in the hands of the UPS driver by giving them your shoe. You are giving them that shoe in hopes that they drop it off. Now, when it comes to like a $100 shoe, I ain't really tripping. But when it comes to a shoe that's $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, no. I need to be responsible. I need to make sure I drop this off. I need to make sure they scan it. I'm not going there for them to box it up and then to put the tracking label on there. I'm doing all that myself, you know, just so I can be sure. I dang near want to follow the UPS truck driver from Illinois all the way to Michigan or Atlanta, wherever the StockX headquarter may be at. I want to make sure I'm following them, especially when it comes to a shoe like this. But also, the guy says again, last time this happened, that was his fault. So at least he acknowledges that was his mistake. He said, "So basically StockX told me I was SHIT out of luck and they couldn't do anything without a drop-off receipt." So what a drop-off receipt is basically when you go to UPS and they scan that StockX label, they're gonna print you out a receipt right then and there, and you take the receipt and you should keep that for your own personal records. Never just go and just drop off packages. For me, for the most part, now, I'm gonna be honest, like, I've done it, But just doing this now is just a reassurance on why you shouldn't do it. And you should just wait there, get your tracking information, make sure it's going to the right spot. So that way you feel more comfortable knowing that, hey, if anything goes wrong, 9 out of 10, it was a mistake on your behalf because you was literally there throughout all of the steps. So again, make sure you are getting that receipt for your own record. Basically, StockX told me I was SHIT out of luck and they couldn't do anything without a drop-off receipt. Even though the tracking update as scanned in an UPS possession. So what he's saying is, even though StockX can see that the package has gone from his original location and is in transit, they still not going to take that because they don't have their receipt showing that the package was dropped off to UPS and that the person actually has, you know, some form of validation to say, hey, I dropped these off. Which I can see in both ways how it can be a little bit of a hiccup. So doing as any sane person would, I did the layer work with UPS myself, and after investigation in it, they honored the insurance on the package and accepted the claim. So he was smart by insuring his package. Now, when I ship out a package to StockX, I don't generally do the insurance. I didn't even know that you can add additional insurance on your packages that you ship off to StockX when you are selling. Again, that's news to me, and that's why I'm sharing this information with the Army. Just for those who are frequent shippers and sellers on StockX, listen to some of the things that happened in this story and just make sure that you're cleaning up whatever, you know, formality that you have been doing over the years. If it needs to be cleaned up. And what I mean by cleaned up is just like if you just drop all packages or if you, you know, give it to the UPS man. Maybe you should put all of that responsibility in your own hands so that way it's no hiccups. Now, here's where it gets real, real tricky. He said, well, only issue is the label was technically created by StockX. So the payout slash claim of $5,340 was sent to StockX. So number one, my man is out of his Air Jordan 1 off-white. He ain't seen them since June 1st since he shipped them out. And now UPS, they accepted the claim, they honored it, but they sent the claim money to StockX because the original label was a StockX label. Now that right there, I'm not 100% sure about how that will work. I would feel like since it was my shoe, I put the claim on it, I should be able to get the money. Now, I'm not sure if he contacted StockX or because of how high a value the shoe is. I've never sold a shoe this high on StockX. Maybe the highest value shoe I've sold on StockX is maybe like $500. So maybe if it's a shoe over $1,000, they add extra insurance on it or something. Again, so for those who frequently sell on StockX, let us know if, you know, if it's over a certain value, StockX adds insurance on it. You let me know that. He say, I reached out to them early yesterday via email to my old email chain with them and no response. Not surprised. He said they ghosted him a year when they owed him $212 for him some Yeezy analogs. He like, so I went ahead and opened another ticket this morning. He said, I'm praying and hoping they will send me my money for the lost product, but StockX is shady. These is his words. These is his words. Again, he said, I'm praying and hoping they will send me my money for the lost product, but StockX is shady, so I'm pretty nervous. Has anyone dealt with a situation like that? After hearing the story, how do y'all feel about it? I did get a message from the individual, and he did let me know that he did hear back from StockX and that is going through an investigation, so he will keep me updated on the results and what actually happened. But what do y'all think is going to happen? I honestly hope that my man's get his money back because I feel like the shoes are gone. If you ship the shoes out on June 1st and it is now the middle of July, you haven't heard from it or seen them, I think the shoes are gone. But if you at least get your money back from the insurance claim that you put on it, I will hope that my mans do get his money, because who wants to be out of a $7,000 shoe and $5,000 of insurance money that he could potentially get? Because he sold the 9.5 for $6,000. They took $480 in transaction fees, and then they took another $180 in processing payment fees, which is a grand total of about $660 in fees alone. Why does it cost $660 to just ship this shoe to get a legit check and then you ship it to another person? That is crazy. And because of that, that's why I've been so high on the Trade Block app. The Trade Block app The fees is $25 to do a trade with somebody. Then they authenticate the shoes with their two-step authentication process. Like, almost $700. See, I didn't even think about that, man. But almost $700 in fees alone, which is beyond me, Army. Again, Army, I hope he get his money back. And sometimes you take situations like this as a learning lesson. I swear to y'all, man. I swear to y'all, right hand up right now. I literally was about to do that yesterday with those Air Jordan 1 Women Low shoes. I'm just like, I don't feel like going to UPS. The UPS man is on his way to deliver something. They already got the label. They already boxed up. I can just hand it to him because I've done it before. I've done it once. It was years ago. But I'm just like, you know what? I'm just go myself. I always like to get the little receipt that they give you, the little receipt that scan out, just for your own personal, just not necessarily satisfaction, but at least you know that you did everything right. And if it goes wrong, you can at least retrace your steps. You ain't got to be like, man, I gave it to this driver. And now, you know, because had he actually went to the UPS store, maybe none of this would have went on. Again, it's all a learning lesson. I just hate it had to be a $6,000 learning lesson. But again, let's hope that he gets his money back. Again, y'all let me know how y'all feel about this in the comment section below. And other than that, you got your boy Unbreakable. You got the Unbreakable Vault Army. When I say it's something big is happening soon for your boy. I cannot wait to tell y'all the news. I can't wait to express how excited and honored and elated I am about this. Bigger things is about to go down over here in the Unbreakable Vault Army. You guys will be along for the ride. I love you guys. Without the Army and the Army support, none of this will be possible. I always have to give y'all credit where y'all credit is due. Army stand strong like always. And like the merch, say hug your loved ones because it's coming soon. And we out.